Guys, welcome back to GoSide. Times footballers blatantly cheated. Football is the most lovable game across the planet. The footballers who put their heart and soul into the game and snatch the game from the jaws of defeat are praised and are seen not a shred less than heroes. But there are times when these heroes blatantly cheat for their benefit and sink in the eyes of the spectators. It's a universal fact that nobody likes a cheater, and the feeling of satisfaction just isn't there anymore after a win. Almost every footballer has cheated at least once in their football career. The players who cheat find no fault in cheating because it eventually leads to their team's victory. Even some fans support that various cheating tactics, such as diving and shirt pulling, are part of the game and, if used correctly, can do greater good than harm. Goals scored by cheating are not frowned upon by the supporters, and why would they? Their team just scored a goal. In this article, we're going to be talking about some of the times footballers cheated so blatantly on the field and off the field that the most untrained eye could catch them in a blink. Some of the times these footballers got away with their acts of cheating while others got caught and were charged with severe punishments. We start our list with the master diver. Yes, you've guessed it right. Neymar Jr. The Brazilian footballer is one of the most recognized faces around the world because of his freestyle skills and agility. The Paris Saint-Germain forward has very quick feet, which leaves the defenders baffled, but he is heavily criticized for diving. For those of you who don't know, diving is an act just of hurling yourself at the ground when a player tries to tackle you, awarding you with a penalty or a free kick. Neymar is often seen diving inside the penalty box and has won many penalties, which led his team. But since the virtual assistant referee, the VAR, has been in the game, Neymar hasn't been able to sneak any more penalties. When Brazil played against Costa Rica in the 2018 World Cup, Neymar dived perfectly and was able to fool the referee as Brazil was awarded the penalty, but it took only a second through the VAR that the foul was actually a dive and the penalty was taken back. A key member of Brazil's 2002 World Cup winning team should be remembered for his bazooka striking power and his solemning runs, but he's remembered instead for his play acting when he besmirched his legacy against the Turkish defender Hakan Unsal. In a tackle, Hakan accidentally chipped a Brazilian on the knee, but Rivaldo went down clutching his face. Unsal was immediately shown a red card and sent off, but the post-match investigation revealed this hoax, and Rivaldo was fined €7,350. However, he continued playing in the tournament past this scandal. The number 7 center forward, who is an animal in the field and has many records attributed to his name, will also dive every now and then, especially when the game is in a deadlock. It sometimes doesn't make sense that Cristiano Ronaldo, definitely the most hardworking and arguably the best footballer of his time, would also need to come to the aid of diving to take his team out of deadlock and win them a match. On October 30th, 2019, the game between Juventus and Genoa, after starting quite uneventfully, resulted in a deadlock with the scoreline of 1-1. But then the Portuguese dived on the very last minute and won a penalty for Juventus, and we all know what happens when Cristiano takes a penalty. The game ended 2-1 with Juventus victorious, but Ronaldo was heavily criticized for this last-minute dive. It's very difficult to comprehend that one of the greatest players of all time can be involved in such huge acts of cheating that it baffles one's mind. Very few expected Diego Maradona to leave a mark in the 1994 World Cup because he wasn't the same player he was in 1986. He was overweight, prone to injury, and way past his peak. But in Argentina's 4-0 win over Greece, Maradona looked exactly the same as in 1986, maybe even better. He was so well balanced, and his silky smooth dribbling had returned. After putting the ball in the top corner, he marched towards the camera, and everybody, after seeing his wild eyes and vein bulging, knew that something was not quite right. After a week, Maradona tested positive for the stimulant ephedrine, which is a performance-enhancing drug, and left the tournament in disgrace. The most iconic piece of skullduggery was done by the same Argentinian legend. In the 1986 World Cup, the most iconic cheating, the Hand of God, was recorded. Maradona came to a one-on-one challenge with England's goalkeeper Peter Shilton, and while the ball was in the air, Maradona leaped forward and punched the ball with his left hand over the goalkeeper's head and into the goal. As he wheeled away, he later revealed he had to urge his teammates to feign celebration, saying, "Come hug me or the referee isn't going to allow it." Surprisingly, the referee allowed the goal to stand as he said that he didn't see a handball. But England manager Bobby Robson had a different perspective, commenting, "It wasn't the hand of God, it was the hand of a rascal."